Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'll explain FMCW radar system in great details. Here, I'll cover basics, working, block diagram, and calculation of range and Doppler frequency of FMCW radar system. Let us begin this session with first agenda, that is basics of FMCW radar system. See, FMCW means frequency modulated continuous wave radar. This system is CW radar system only, but here transmitted signal, that is frequency modulated one, means transmitted frequency will be changing with respect to time. In basic CW radar system, we transmit constant frequency. Here with FMCW radar system, transmitted frequency will be changing with respect to time. So here we are modulating transmitted frequency. Based on FMCW radar system, we can identify range as well as motion of the target using beat frequency. I'll explain you how to identify beat frequency. First of all, you should know beat frequency, that is FR plus or minus FD, where velocity identification that we do with the use of plus or minus FD, that is Doppler frequency, and range calculation that we do with the use of FR frequency, that is range frequency. In this video, I'll be deriving equations of FR and FD based on block diagram. First of all, one should know FMCW radar system, that is frequency modulated continuous wave radar system, where transmitted signal frequency will be changing with respect to time, and based on the received echo signal, we identify beat frequency, and beat frequency is FR plus or minus FD. Based on FR, we identify range of the target, and based on FD, we identify motion of the target, means velocity of the target. Here, if target is stationary, then you will be observing this Doppler frequency, that will be zero, means beat frequency is equals to range frequency. But range frequency cannot be equals to zero. The reason is, obviously, target will be there at some distance, right? And in my last video, I have derived range calculation based on range frequency. So you just go through that video even. Based on that, you can easily understand how we can identify range from range frequency. Now, let us see block diagram of FMCW radar system. Block diagram of FMCW radar system consists three major elements. First is antenna, second is transmitter, and third is receiver. Here, if you observe, we have two separate antennas. One antenna is there for a transmitter, and second antenna is there for receiver. Because of we have two separate antennas for a transmitter and receiver, we have excellent isolation in between transmitter and receiver section. Here, see transmitter that is functioning at high power, and receiver that is functioning at low power. The reason is received signal will be echo signal, that is there in terms of 10 to the power minus 12 volt to 10 to the power minus 15 volt, while transmitted signal that is there in terms of few kilovolts to megavolts. So it is very essential to have isolation in between transmitter and receiver. Because of two separate antennas are used, here we can have excellent isolation in between transmitter and receiver circuit. Now I'll be discussing about transmitter section. If you talk about transmitter section, then here we have FMCW radar system where we will be transmitting signal which will be frequency modulated one. For that, here we use FM modulator, and here FM modulator is modulating signal at output side based on triangular wave. By black color you can observe transmitted signal, and that transmitted signal frequency that is changing as per a triangular pattern, right? Here we will be changing frequency with respect to time, and based on function which is triangular one, here we will be changing our transmitted frequency as per a triangular pattern, right? Here this delta f, that is total deviation of frequency, and that deviation of frequency that is happening as per rate, that is 1 by fm. Here, see, we will be transmitting high power, high frequency over here, and transmitted signal that will be F0T over here. And that F0 is frequency which will be changing with respect to time based on this triangular function. Same F0t that is also given to receiver as a reference. So you can observe here same signal that we give it to receiver over here as a reference. In the receiver section, I'll explain you how it is useful. So transmitted signal that will be having change in frequency continuously as per this function, and that we do it with the use of FM modulator over here, right? So transmitter is transmitting high power signal, that is frequency modulated signal. Here, that frequency modulation that we do it with the use of FM modulator. And for example, here I have considered triangular wave frequency modulation, right? Where this is not amplitude, just try to understand this. This is frequency deviation with respect to time, right? Now let us talk about receiver section. In the receiver section, here we will be receiving very weak echo signal, that is F0t dash, where this signal that is weak in terms of power, that power could be there in terms of 10 to the power minus 12 to 10 to the power minus 15 volt. Here, first this signal will be given to mixer, and here reference signal that will be given to mixer from FM transmitter. See, mixer will be homodyne mixer over here. Homodyne mixer means what? Here we will be comparing two comparable frequencies. See, in heterodyne, we will be giving two signals where frequencies will be completely different. But in homodyne mixer, two comparable frequencies will be given. Here, one signal that is having F0t frequency and second signal that is having F0-t. This deviation in frequency over here, that will happen based on motion of target as well as range of target. But that deviation will not be too high. Like if you transmit 5 gigahertz of signal, then deviation will be there in terms of few megahertz at maximum by few megahertz, right? So here you don't have that much deviation in this received signal. So these two signals frequency that is comparable over here, right? And that's why we use homodyne mixture. This homodyne mixture will be generating bead signal frequency over here, that will be difference of these two frequency. So difference of these two frequency will be bead frequency, that even I'll explain you in graph, that will give you more clarity. That bead frequency that is given to amplifier and then limiter. After that, that bead frequency that is given to frequency counter. And this frequency counter that will be separating range frequency and Doppler frequency. Based on that, we can identify range and velocity. Now, I'll begin to explain you calculation of range frequency and Doppler frequency, by which you can easily understand how to identify range and motion of target. To understand range frequency and Doppler frequency, first of all, you need to understand what is bead frequency. See, bead frequency that is generated by mixture, that is a difference in between received echo signal frequency and transmitted frequency. Here, transmitted signal frequency that is F0t and received signal frequency that is F0t dash. Difference in between these two frequency, that is bead frequency over here at the output of this mixture. So here, if you observe transmitted signal, so that is shown by black color, and that we modulate over here as per a triangular pattern. In FMCW radar system, we transmit frequency modulated signal. Here we have modulation as per triangular pattern. If you observe this dashed line, that is received echo signal, and its frequency is also varying as per triangular pattern only. Here, difference in between these two frequency that is happening based on two parameters, range frequency and Doppler frequency. In total, we can say bead frequency. I have explained bead frequency is what? If you talk about bead frequency, then bead frequency is range frequency plus or minus Doppler frequency. So here, when this triangular wave is rising, at that time, you see difference in between these two frequency that is lower over here, means this will be range frequency minus Doppler frequency. But when this triangular wave that is falling over here, at that time, this difference means beat frequency that is higher over here means it is FR plus FD. See here, what we are considering is, we are considering target is moving towards radar. As if target is moving towards radar, at that time, during rising of frequency at transmitted side, there will be beat frequency that is FR minus FD, and during falling, it will be FR plus FD. As if target is moving away at that time, during rising, here beat frequency will be FR plus FD, and during falling, it will be FR minus FD, right? So beat frequency means difference in frequencies in between transmitted and received echo signal, right? Now here we have beat frequency that we have seen it in this graph, right? Now based on this, one can easily calculate range frequency and Doppler frequency. See here, let us consider here this wave is going up. So during up, if you observe during up of beat frequency, here we have FR minus FD. And when this transmitted signal that is going down means beat frequency during down, that is how much? That is FR plus FD, right? These two equations that is been received over here means this value that will be there at frequency counter over here. Now what frequency counter will do is, frequency counter will be calculating FR and FD from this. Let us say this is equation 1, this is equation 2. So here what frequency counter does is, frequency counter will be taking summation of these two. So based on that, you will be having FR calculation. If you add these two, then you will be having beat frequency up plus beat frequency down divided by 2, that is FR. And if you wanted to have Doppler frequency FD, then simply you need to take difference of these two, means beat frequency down minus beat frequency up divided by 2, that is Doppler frequency, right? So here, see, this is what the waveform that we'll be having at frequency counter over here. And with this frequency counter, by just simply solving these two equations, we can have range frequency and Doppler frequency. Now, once you have range frequency and Doppler frequency, you can easily calculate range and velocity. I have explained range calculation based on range frequency in my last video. Let me explain that again. See, if you want to calculate range, then range will be C into FR divided by 4 delta F into FM. And here you can observe this parameter where FR is this range frequency, right? So I can say this FR is this, right? So here range frequency, that is identifying range over here, where this delta F and FM that I have already explained over here in this graph, you can observe, right? And if you wanted to have velocity of target based on Doppler frequency, then velocity VR, that is lambda FD by 2. So based on range frequency and Doppler frequency, we can identify range and motion of the target. I hope you have understood this. Still, if anything that you would like to share, please note it down in comment section. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.